class 9 as we were studying the chapter packing. So quite an interesting one. Humorous account of the packing of the three friends. Okay. And what they have done that like while packing, they are displaying various qualities of their behavior. Okay. So what we have come to know out of, you can say out of the account that we have read till now. So what we have found? Out for George, Harris, as well as irresponsible, creating more mess, na? Creating more chaos. Also, they were creating a lot of chaos, having unmanageable nature. Okay, they did not know how to manage the things. Okay, childlike behavior they were also showing. When the butter was stuck at the back and they were looking around and they were coming in the center of the room also again, right? So these kind of qualities, they have been shown by them. And ultimately we have come to know this means actually the see, what is the motive of the writer? Okay, he wanted actually to display us that he is going on a journey to River Thames, first desk please. And later on, just see what he has come out with. Okay, right? So next afterwards, coming up to the next page. Okay. 1 minute, please. Yes, we were reading from the last line, 12 paragraph. We have to start para 12. So Montmorency was in it all, of course. Montmorency's ambition in life is to get in the way and be sworn at. So who's Montmorency here? The dog. Okay, the dog was in it all. Means Montmorency was equally involved in all this packing. And his sole ambition in life is to get in the way and be sworn at. Means to get in way of everything and to spoil it. Okay. So if he can squirm in anywhere, squirm means move around, where he particularly is not wanted, and be a perfect nuisance and make people mad and have things thrown at his head, he feels his day has not been wasted. Means see the nature in one line, the writer has completely explained about his nature, that what kind of, you can say, nature the dog has. Means if he is not intruding in any activity, okay, if he is not wandering, or if it is not moving around without any reason, he thought that the day is not at all complete. And moreover, if a person would not throw a thing at his head because of as a result of utter nuisance, then what the dog thinks, the day is not at all complete. Okay, so it means that the dog is, you can say, adding more trouble to the normal task. Okay. To get somebody to stumble over him and curse him steadily for an hour is his highest aim and object. See, highest aim and object means what is the highest main thing what the dog always wanted was that to stumble, so that he will be always be sitting on the way, and otherwise when someone is busy in the work, he would stumble over him. Okay. And this always he wanted. And when he has succeeded in accomplishing this, his conceit becomes quite unbearable. Okay, conceit here is means that he feels pride that I have accomplished the same. Actually, the dog is not feeling so. The writer wants to display us that it is the nature of the dog that he is doing in this manner. So it is because of this reason that it has been mentioned. So he came and sat down on things just when they were wanted to be packed, and he labored under the fixed belief that whatever Harris or George reached out their hand for anything, it was his cold damp. Damp means wet nose that they wanted. So see, what he's doing, all the things they were, you can say, they were spilled around the room. Okay, they were scattered around the room. They were sitting on these things. And while packing, when one's attention is towards the bag or towards the hampers, they would stretch their hands, for example, in this manner to pick up the things, right? Okay, and ultimately what is coming in their hands? Only the damp nose of the dog. It means that he is thinking that they are grabbing for my nose, and he will extend his face so that they can catch hold of it. So it was his cold, damp nose. He put his leg into the jam and he worried the teaspoons and he pretended that the lemons were rats and got into the hamper and killed three of them before Harris could land him with the frying pan. See, he put his leg into the jam means spoiled the jam. Finally, what happened? There were lemons packed in the hamper. He thought that they were rats and he attacked over them into the hamper and finally killed three, means smashed completely, squeezed three lemons. Okay, and finally, you can say Harris, he got irritated of his this behavior and he took a frying pan and hit it on the head. Okay, so it means dog was equally adding to the trouble of the family. Harris said, I encouraged him. I didn't encourage him. So Harris said, I didn't encourage him to do. A dog like that doesn't want any encouragement. It's the natural, original sin that is born in him that makes him to do the things like that. Now what Harris is saying, Harris is saying that it is not actually he who is, you can say, it is not he who has encouraged the dog to commit this kind of mischief actually. Actually, the dog was doing it just because of his own reason, okay? Because he is born with this kind of nature that he is always creating one mess or the other. And it is because of this reason that he is doing this. The packing was done at 12:50, finally. Okay. And Harris sat on the big hamper. Okay. Where he sat on the big hamper and said he hoped nothing would be found broken. And when he sat out of tiredness, then he said, oh my God, I hope that nothing should be broken. George said that if anything was broken, it was broken, which reflection seemed to comfort him. But George said, so now nothing to do with that. If anything is broken, now it is broken. We are helpless to do anything. He also said he was ready for bed. We were ready for bed. Harris was to sleep with us that night and we went upstairs. Finally, it was the time for sleeping and they slept and Harris, they have to sleep along with them. We tossed for bed. So now like small children, they were tossing. I will sit on the wall side and I will sit on the outer side. They has to sleep with me, he said. Do you prefer the inside or the outside, Jay? So Harris, yes, he has to share a bed with Jaram. He said, what would you like, inside or outside? Inside means towards the wall and outside means towards the open area. I said, generally preferred to sleep inside the bed. Harris said it was odd. George said, what time shall I wake you, fellow? So he said, I prefer the inside one, Jaram said. So George asked, now, friends, tell me, at one time we should wake up? Harry said, 7. I said, no, 6. So they were again having a conflicting viewpoints for the time when they should wake up because I wanted to write some letters. He said, I think that at 6 we should because I have to write some important letters to be posted. So Harry said, I had a bit of row over it. But at last, split the difference and said 6:30. Finally, when they were fighting 6:07, Harry said, okay, fine. 6:30 is fine. Okay. He settled upon a common thing. Okay. Like when I had a bit row over it means he was not satisfied with that. Okay. So George made no answer. George said nothing. And we found on going over that he had been asleep for some time. So we placed the bath where he could tumble into it on getting out in the morning and went to bed ourselves. So what they did, where George was sleeping, they put the bath so that when he would wake up, he would tumble over it, okay, in order to irritate him. And finally, what happened? They receded back to their beds. Okay, and that's all for this chapter, packing, right? So very funny account, short one, right? And now coming back to the question answers. Okay. But before those question answers, you have to write down a story in your fair notebooks. Take out your fair notebooks. I will discuss the question answers afterwards. Story. Okay. Right. I'm discussing the format of a story. Thank you. So now story writing, as we have already discussed also a number of times, that what a story is, it is a descriptive account or it is a description of the events which revolve around the life of characters. So mainly we take moderate number of characters, not very less, not too much, so that the reader will be confused in the lives of those characters only, right? So the moderate number of characters is the best rule. Okay, and now for story writing, you know, it is based upon the cause and effect relationship. Okay, cause of one and the effect of the other person. Okay, so it includes this, right? So for story writing, you know, first of all, you are going to write down the title, right? After title, you will develop the story, but in various, you can say various certain elements you will take into account that must be included in your story writing. So first of all, para one, set up the plot and introduce the characters. Okay, so what you will do, you will set up the plot. This you also have to note down in your fair notebooks. Okay, set up the plot and introduce the characters. So when you set up the plot, you will set up that where is this taking place, the story is of, the background of the story, and you will explain it. Okay, and you will introduce the characters also, right? Then para two, you will develop the story further, right? What you will do, you will develop the story further. Further, you will develop the story by elaborating the characters, by elaborating the incidents which are related to the life of the characters, by explaining the various happenings that are ongoing in the life of the characters, right? Then afterwards, in para three, raise a problem which the main character is facing. Okay, so you will raise the problem which the main character is facing. Okay, right? So which the main character is facing, you will raise that problem, and or the problem, it will be revolved around the life, or it will be revolving around the life of the main character. Means the main character must be included in that problem. Then para four, create suspense and do not give the solution to the problem immediately, right? So you will not give solution to the problem immediately. Okay, you have to create suspense. Let the readers guess. Okay, so when the readers guess, they will show involvement, and when they show involvement, there you can say interest will arouse, and ultimately they will find it interesting to read the story which is written by you. And while developing all these parts, you will definitely include dialogues. Okay, short and long. The type of sentences you can have of varied type. Okay, simple, complex, and compound sentences you will use. Okay, right? And then yes, para five, give solution, yes, to the problem in an unexpected manner. Then you will give the solution to the problem in an unexpected manner. Okay, so in an unexpected manner, just a moment, please. So you will give solution to the problem in an unexpected manner. Okay, so that, as I have already given you number of times the example. Okay, so can anybody now in this context of this packing can tell how all these elements are applicable here? You have read the chapter packing. See, first in the very first paragraph, it is mentioned that they were planning for a journey, right? The three main characters, Jerem, George and Harris, were introduced. And the very first paragraph, their natures have also been depicted, so that the reader will have an idea in their minds, okay, or in his mind or his or her mind, yes, that this is going. Okay, formation of character. Okay, then further, Jerem started packing. He has given little background of his experiences. It means the story is developing further. Okay, then afterwards, the problem. Okay, how the problem was introduced there? He has to pack, unpack. Sometimes he left his boots in. Sometimes he has forgotten to pack the soap, and he has left the toothbrush also, right? And finally, it was done. Little bit of relaxation. Now, suspense, how it has been created. Now it is the turn of George and Harris to pack the hampers. And in order to arouse the excitement, he has added, or the writer has added, an element of humor there. Right? And ultimately, what has happened, that they were making a lot of chaos. Okay, finally, Montmorency and an unexpected character introduced in between. Okay? Means whenever an unexpected character is introduced, it doesn't mean that this character is not holding any kind of importance. It means that character is equally important in the story. Okay, without which the story would have been a plain sequence of incidents, right? So then afterwards, solution to the problem in an unexpected manner, finally with a great chaos, great disturbance, finally the packing was done at 12:15, right? So moral is optional. If any is there, you can write down. Or if moral is not written, it doesn't mean that it's not a part of a story, right? The marks will not be deducted at all for it. Okay? Fine? Right? So for story writing, it is complete. So now you have to write down one story in your notebooks, right? One question. I woke up in a dizzy manner, being free after so many days. But the excitement of being free did not last long. As and then finally, you have to complete it. Right? So, write a story on the basis of given outline. In an interesting way. So you have to write down the story in an interesting way, right? So this story, it should be written in your notebooks, and please note down it. Purvi, one plait, why? Two plaits. Right now, so you have to develop this story further. Okay, so write in the most interesting way. Okay, you will introduce the dialogues, and of course, you will add on the other elements which you feel seems to be interesting. Okay, and this you have to write down in your notebooks. And remember that before writing the question answers of packing, this story is must. Okay. Now you should practice your writing skills also. It's very much important. Okay. So that's all, right?